create a single page or multi-page website with a well-thought-out, user-friendly design using a visual website builder, no coding skills are required. Choose and customize pre-made templates that suit your business or create your own from scratch. With our website builder, you only need to select an element, drag it to the workspace, and customize its style to fit your business tasks. You can add payment options, subscription forms, and image galleries, and include links to your social media profiles or blog to attract and convert visitors into customers. To create a website, go to the Website tab and click Create Website. Then click New Site. Site templates are currently under development. Before you start adding elements, choose your template style. By default, the color scheme and text style you select will be applied to all the elements you use. You can also set or change the overall style of your website after it's created. Think about your website structure and start to build it using the block, section, column, and widget elements. By default, one block with the section is already included in the workspace. You can add an unlimited number of blocks and up to 6 columns to one section. Once you're done with your page structure and its main elements, you can move on to widgets. To add a widget, click inside a column or section on the plus icon and select a widget from the panel. Add the menu widget to the top of your page. To edit a menu item, click on the pencil icon. To add a new item to your menu, click Add. Select your website page or enter a link, email address, phone number, or anchor link to another block. You can choose whether to open the link in a new window or the same one. Edit text style and menu layout. Use the text to add a text element to your page. To change the formatting, click on the text itself and you'll be able to edit it. Change the color and font of specific parts of your text to highlight keywords and headings. You can also add lists, hyperlinks, or additional items using source code. Button is used to add buttons with links to other sites, pages, and blocks, or communicate via phone or email. You can include additional buttons or align your button when editing it. To customize the button, click the pencil icon. Enter your button name and hint in the description. Select its type. Link. Used to insert a full link in the https://example.com format. If you select the Open in New Window option, the link will be opened in a new browser tab when a user clicks on it. Email. Used to insert an email address. Phone number. Used to insert a phone number in the international format. By clicking on such a link, users will be able to call the specified phone number from their browser or device using built-in applications. Anchor link. Used to insert an anchor link that leads to another block. By clicking on the link, the visitor will be immediately redirected to the specified block. You can get the anchor ID in the block settings. Select your button style. By default, your primary and secondary overall page styles are applied. You can also create a unique style for each button separately. To do this, select the Custom option. With the Image widget, you can add a multimedia element to your page. Add visual elements that enhance your text. Once you've added the widget, go to the Element Editor, select a file, or upload a new one. Your image height affects the height of the entire section, so think about your structure, page design, and image size in advance. To add extra elements to your image, click the pencil icon next to it. You can enter alternative text and add a description and a link. Customize the text you'll use for your image by changing its size, color, and position, and adding a background to it. Once you've made all the necessary changes to the button, click Save. You can also change your image size, align it with the column it's added to, add a shadow, or round the corners. If you want to add a video, you must first upload it to YouTube or Vimeo and then include a link to it. Use a spacer and divider to visually separate your content, blocks, sections, columns, or widgets. Pay attention that indentation affects the section's width and the column's height. When adding the spacer widget, you can set the height size in pixels. You can select the color, type, thickness, and size of your divider element. For example, if you need a line for the entire column, you can set the width to 100%. If you need it for a smaller element, you set it to 50%. Align your content left, right, or center. Collect your site visitors' data using a subscription form. By default, every time you get a new lead, your CRM system creates a new deal. Enter a deal name and select a pipeline where you want to add your new contacts. You can also save contacts to your mailing list to send them campaigns later. Select a mailing list where your new contacts will be stored. Then customize your form fields and subscription button. You can add a link to your social media profile to invite users to follow you. To add a link to your social media profile, click Add. Then click on the pencil icon, select the social media platform, and enter your profile link. Customize your element by displaying it as a button or icon, or choosing its color and alignment. You can also add a button to offer users to subscribe to your chatbot and launch the desired flow, for example, a welcome flow or a customized flow. You can choose your button style and customize it. Then, add a new element or edit an existing one by specifying a social network. You can add the countdown element to set a countdown timer until the start of an event or the end of a sale. Enter your end date and time and message. Set the date options, and customize your countdown timer. Use the FAQ element to add detailed answers to frequently asked questions from your users. To change the text and formatting, click on your text or heading, and you'll be able to edit it. You can add a new question when editing your widget. Change your icon style, add or remove a spacer or divider, and choose its color. Once you create your website, you can see what it will look like on different devices. To do this, click Preview at the top of the screen. Choose which device you want to see the preview on, desktop or mobile. Once you've finished creating the page, click Save and Edit. Enter your website name and link. When adding a new page, enter its URL. Afterward, you'll be able to publish, customize, copy, or delete a new page. To change your page title and URL, go to Settings, enter a new title and URL. By default, the first page you add when creating a website is considered its main page. To change your main page, select a new page from the drop-down menu. Please note that you can select your website's main page only if there are two or more pages. You can connect your domain, add a favicon, and remove the SendPulse logo on a paid plan. You can connect Google Analytics. To connect the Facebook pixel and meta tag, as well as add third-party code, you need to upgrade to a paid plan. You can also monitor your website visit statistics. To do this, go to the Statistics tab and select a statistics type you want to track. Publish the selected page or all pages.